Hello everyone. In today's video, we are going to cover the following topics. Hard connective tissue. From name, it is very clear. Hard connective tissue. So the types of hard connective tissues are given here. So you can see two types are given. One is bone, second is cartilage. So bone, this is hard porous tissue. This is unable to bend. If you try to bend the bone, it will break. The cell present in the bones, they are known as osteoblast. Like bone cells are known as osteoblast. Inside the bone, blood supply is also there and nerve supply is also there. Right? In cartilage. So cartilage is made up of chondroblast. Chondroblast means cartilage cell. So cartilage is flexible. But inside cartilage, there is no blood supply and no nerve supply. The tip of your nose or your external ear, all are having cartilage inside it. So this is the reason you can bend your ear easily. Right? And the position of bone, it is very clear to everyone. So this makes the framework of our body. This is the skeleton system. So let's see the example of cartilage present in the external ear. So you can see this is external ear. So and we can bend this. Why we can bend this? Because of the presence of cartilage in it, right? Next we have fluid connective tissue. This is the third type of connective tissue. Let's see its types. Fluid means liquid. So the tissue which is present in liquid form inside our body, it is blood, it is lymph. So let's start with blood. So this is red colored fluid present in our body. It is having three type of cells and one is plasma. So first is RBC, they transport oxygen. Second is WBC, they fight with germs, they provide immunity to our body. Then comes platelets, they help in the clotting of blood. And last, plasma is a liquid part of the blood. It transports different substances such as waste material, food substances, hormones, antibodies. All these are transported with the help of plasma. Then move to lymph. Lymph is having only two components. One is WBC, second is plasma. Same function of WBC, fight with the germs, and plasma function, transport different substances. So overall function of blood is, it transport different substances, and function of lymph, it protect us from germs and diseases. Okay, individual function you can easily remember from here. So this was the end of connective tissue. So you can see on the screen. So this was connective tissue in detail, having all the three parts discussed in detail. Next tissue is nervous tissue. So in nervous tissue, we have nerve cells, or nerve cell is also known as neuron. So regarding nervous tissue, only the structure of neuron is important. So look at this. This is the structure of neuron. So here, this is the center portion of the cell, which is known as cyton. It is having quite small and numerous processes which are known as dendrites, and a single long process. So this is known as axon. The ends of axons are further having tiny branches. So it is known as axon terminal. Right? So you can see inside the cyton we have nucleus. So it is labeled with pink color. And on axon, a covering is present. Here, with yellow, I have represented it. This covering is known as myelin sheath. So this is not continuous. It is having breakage in between. Right? So wherever the breakage is present, that portion is known as node of Ranvier. So this is the nervous tissue. Nervous tissue is present in brain, spinal cord, and nerves present in our body. So it help in transporting messages from one part of the body to another. Due to this system, we are sensitive to different substances. We can smell, we can taste, we can feel something. Right? So with this, our chapter ends here. So must prepare your chapter properly and do exercise and question timely. Thank you, students.